The next flat up. A guard is driving down a Connell Street in Dublin when he sees two fellas pissing up against the window of a shop. He parks the car and runs over to them. He asks the first fella for his name and address. The man replies, "I'm Paddy O'Toole of No Fixed Abode." The guarder turns to the second fella and asks the same question. He replies, "I'm Ben Riordan, and I live in the flat above Paddy." Dilurira. Anto's missus was in the Rotunda Hospital, ready to give birth to their first child. When they arrived, the nurse asked, "How dilated is she, sir?" Anto replied, "Delighted. She's over the fucking moon. Ordering a pint. Sorry, love, can I have a pint of Guinness and a packet of crisps where you're ready there?" "Oh. You must be Irish," she replied. The man was evidently offended and responded, "The cheek, just because I order a pint of Guinness you assume I'm Irish. If I ordered a bowl of pasta would you that make me Italian?" "No," she replied. "But this is a news agent's. More sheep." "Yes, this is another potentially offensive and dirty Irish joke involving sheep. An Irish farmer was walking along the boundary between his and his neighbor's fields when he spotted his neighbor carrying two sheep in his arms. "Tony," he called. "Are you going to shear those sheep?" "I am not," the neighbor replied, "they're both for me." An English lawyer was sat with his Irish client. "Marty," he sighed, "why is it that whenever you ask an Irishman a question, he replies with another question?" "Bollocks." "Who told you that?" asked Marty. "Death by Guinness." It was a cold Friday evening when the doorbell rang in Mrs. Molloy's house. When she answered the door, Pat Glynn, her husband's manager at the brewery, was stood on the doorstep. "Pat." "Hello. Where's my husband?" "He should have been home from work 3 hours ago." The man sighed. "I'm sorry to be the one to tell you this, Mrs. Molloy, but there was an accident over in the brewery. Your husband fell into a vat of Guinness and drowned." "Oh my God," she replied. "Please tell me it was quick." "Well, no. It wasn't. He climbed out 4 times to take a piss. Ben walked into the local bar all a fluster and ordered 7 shots of whiskey and a pint of Smithwick's. When the barman arrived back with the pint, all of the shots of whiskey had been drunk." "Ah, here, you drank those very quickly," said the barman. "Well," says Ben, "if you had what I had, you'd drink them quickly, too." "Shite," replied the barman. "What do you have?" "A tenner," replied Ben. Two Irish lads were working for the local county council. One lad would dig a hole and the other lad would follow him and fill the hole in. They worked up along one street and then down the other. They then moved to the next street and did the same, working flat out all day without stopping. One lad digging the holes. The other lad filling them in. A passerby saw what they were doing and was amazed at the hard work, but couldn't understand what they were at. So, he shouted over to the lad digging the holes, "I don't get it, why do you dig a hole, only for the other lad to fill it in?" The lad wiped his brow and sighed deeply, "Well, I suppose it probably does look a bit odd. You see, we're normally a 3-man team. But today the lad who plants the trees phoned in sick. An Irishman was in New York patiently waiting to cross a busy street. There was a traffic cop manning the crossing. The cop stopped after a few minutes and told those waiting to cross the road, 'Okay pedestrians,' he said, 'let's go.' The Irishman stood waiting, growing more and more frustrated. After 5 minutes he shouted to the cop, 'Here. The pedestrians crossed ages ago, when's it time for the Catholics? Here's one for you, what's Irish and sits outside all day and night. Patio furniture. Did you hear about the fella from Mayo that was born with 2 left feet? He went out the other day and bought some flip-flips.' A man from Cork was in with his doctor. 'Look, David. I've some bad news and some terrible news for you.' 'God. What's the bad news?' asked the patient. 'Well,' replied the doctor, 'you only have 3 days to live.' 'You're joking,' says the patient. 'How on earth can the news get any worse?' 'Well,' says the doctor, 'I've been trying to get hold of you for the past 2 days. What do you call an Irishman with a case of chicken pox?' 'A leper shown.' Anto and his wife were lying in bed in their house in Dublin one Saturday morning. It was 8 o'clock and the neighbor's dog was going mental. 'Fuck this,' shouted Anto as he ran out of the room. He arrived back up the stairs 10 minutes later. 'What are you after doing?' replied his wife. 'I've put the little bastard in our garden. Let's see how they like listening to the little B*** starred. Right, what do you call a bulletproof Irishman? Ricochet. How come you never borrow a few quid from a leprechaun? Because they are always a little short. Three lads from Roscommon were getting paid to take part in a survey about tea drinking. One of the questions was, how do you stir sugar into your tea? I stir it in with my left hand, replied the first lad. I stir it in with my right, replied the second. What does an Irishman get after eating a load of Italian food? Gaelic breath. Two lads were on opposite sides of the River Lee in Cork. How do I get to the other side of the river? Shouted one lad to the other. Sure you're on the other side, replied the second. Why are there only a handful of Irish lawyers in London? Because only a few of them could pass the bar. Did you hear about the cross-eyed teacher in the National School in Westport? He resigned because he couldn't control his pupils. What do you call a huge Irish spider? A padlong legs. A Cork man went for a job at the local stables. When he sat down for the interview, the farmer asked him, have you ever shot horses? Two Irishmen were walking out of a funeral. One turns to the other and says, it was a beautiful ceremony, wasn't it? It was, replied the friend. Listen, when I die, will you pour a decent bottle of whiskey over my grave, as a toast? I will, says the friend. But would you mind if I run it through my kidneys first? A lad from Clare went to his local doctor with cramps from constipation. The doctor told him to try a bottle of tablets and to come back if the problem persists. A week later the lad comes back. Well, are you feeling any better? Asked the doctor. No, the man replied. Was I definitely meant to shove them up my ass? Did you hear about the Irishman who took his car for its first service? He got it stuck between the church doors. What do you call a nun with a washing machine on her head?